Hello and welcome class 10 students. We are learning about different birth control measures in human body. In the previous class, we have started the different methods. We'll continue with method 1. That is different barrier methods. Barrier methods which are condoms and diaphragm. Condoms and diaphragms. Condoms are used by males by putting them as a covering on the penis. So condoms and diaphragms are helpful which prevent the sperm from meeting with the ovum. It is very important to know that by using barrier methods, male and female can avoid the different sexually transmitted diseases like AIDS, syphilis or gonorrhea. So barrier method is the most useful method which protect the persons from different sexually transmitted diseases. Some other methods of preventing fertilization are the use of pills, oral pills or vaginal pills, or use of contraceptive device, and finally the surgical methods. So we'll continue with the chemical methods. The females use two type of pills, oral pills and vaginal pills, which are made of specific drugs. These oral pills contain hormones which stop the ovaries from releasing ovum or egg. These are also known as oral contraceptive pills or OCP. It is a very effective method of preventing pregnancy so long as the pills are taken at the right time. However, some women show some unpleasant side effects on taking of these pills because of change in hormonal balance in the body. So some women prefer to choose oral pills as contraceptives. The most popular brand is Malardy. However, they may experience some unpleasant side effects because the oral contraceptives change the hormonal balance in their body. Whereas the vaginal pills contain spermicides which kill the sperms and thus fertilization is prevented. Next, it is the use of IUCD or intrauterine contraceptive device, popularly known as copper T. A copper T is placed inside the uterus by a doctor or a trained nurse. The IUCD or copper T prevents the implantation of fertilized egg in the uterus. So IUCD prevents implantation of fertilized egg in the uterus. If a woman uses a copper T as a method for avoiding unwanted pregnancies, copper T cannot protect her from acquiring sexually transmitted diseases. Okay, so STDs are not prevented. STDs are not prevented, and IUCD cannot prevent sexually transmitted diseases, which the barrier methods can prevent. Lastly, surgical methods. These are available for both male and female. In case of male, small portion of sperm duct or vas deferens is removed by operative method, and both the cut ends are ligated or tied properly. This prevents sperms from coming out. The surgical method carried out in male is known as vasectomy. It is called vasectomy. Whereas in female, small portion of the oviduct is removed by operative method and the cut ends are ligated. This is known as tubectomy. This prevents egg from entering into the oviducts. So vasectomy and tubectomy are the two surgical methods. Now, so students, many of you have heard about AIDS. This picture is showing a person suffering from AIDS, which is caused by the virus, human immunodeficiency virus or HIV. What happens in this? In this disease, immune system of patient would be damaged, making his body so weak that it cannot protect itself against even common infections like cold and cough. The patient just wait to die. So AIDS is one of the sexually transmitted diseases. So now we will talk about STD or sexually transmitted diseases. The diseases which are spread by sexual contact with an infected person are called STDs. Thus, a healthy person can get STD by making sexual contact with an infected person. The most common in our country are gonorrhea, syphilis, and AIDS, that is acquired immune deficiency syndrome. While gonorrhea and syphilis are caused by bacteria, AIDS is caused by HIV virus. Gonorrhea and syphilis are caused by bacteria. These bacteria spread through sexual contact with the infected person. So the common symptoms of these are burning sensation at urination, passing of urethral discharge with pus in it, and sores in the genitals, that is the genital passages. Although these two are curable diseases. While AIDS damages the body immune system so badly, AIDS is caused by the virus HIV. HIV or human immunodeficiency virus destroy the white blood cells. White blood cells, which can destroy the disease-causing germs and protect a person's body, get infected with this HIV. Therefore, immunity becomes reduced of the body to fight diseases. Due to this, the normal diseases, which are quite normal, like mild cold and cough, fever, can kill a person who is infected with HIV. Here you can see the magnified original view of HIV. Here is the diagrammatic structure of HIV or AIDS virus. We can see that there are different or many layers which are covering the internal genetic part of the virus. There is protein envelope, lipid membrane, okay, protein coat, lipid membrane, and so inside it the single stranded RNA, which is the genetic material of HIV. RNA is the genetic material. So the genetic material is protected through many coats. Therefore, the virus is protected and it's very difficult to kill. So far, no medicine or vaccine has been developed to cure AIDS. So, once infected with AIDS, a person is sure to die in a short span of time. Following some steps may help in controlling the disease. Like, people should be educated about AIDS transmission. Always disposable syringes and needles should be used for injection purpose. Sexual contact with unknown person should always be avoided. The high risk group should refrain from donating blood. Sterilized needles must be provided to drug addicts. Before receiving blood for transfusion, one should ensure that it is not been infected with HIV. and always a common razor at the barber shop should not be used. So these are few steps through which AIDS can be prevented once it is infected. Out of age, sexual contact with unknown person is strictly prohibited. So now we have come to an end with the chapter sexual reproduction. Students, please go through the chapter, read and learn thoroughly. Thank you very much, all of you. See you soon in the next class.